The Ghibli is an intriguing alternative to a Mercedes-AMG E63. It doesn't have the outright performance to live with cars such as this, yet is priced to look as if it should at £73,840. But at least it now drives a lot better than it once did, with excellent new electric steering. Plus, there's no denying it has a style and charm outside and in that the German cars at this level lack. It's an eccentric choice, for sure. Maserati has come a long way in a relatively short period of time since its rebirth in 2013, and so far the Ghibli has been one of its greatest successes, commercially if not dynamically. Based unashamedly on the larger, longer Quattro port, it's just been thoroughly revised both above and beneath the skin to a point where Maserati claims this latest version is 70% brand new. The big news mechanically concerns the steering, which has gone from a conventional hydraulic setup to a fully electric system. Maserati claims, however, that the car steers better than ever in terms of the feel and precision it delivers, while also pointing out that it benefits from the more obvious gains in economy and efficiency at the same time. Also new is a range of electronic safety features designed to make the Ghibli as easy to drive but also as secure as possible on the road. These include adaptive cruise control, clever new intelligent LED headlights, lane keep assist, steering assist, and brake force assist, hence the reason the car has just received a full 5-star rating from NCAP. Styling changes inside and out have unquestionably improved the overall look and feel of the car in numerous places. It now appears genuinely elegant on the road but also distinctly sporting in style. Never more so than in Grand Sport guise as tested here. In Gran Lusso form the styling is a touch less aggressive, with the emphasis more on luxury than sporting intent. But in both guises the revised Ghibli looks good and looks expensive. Which is just as well given the price of the S model you see here, for at £73,840 the Ghibli Grand Sport S competes with some seriously big hitting rivals in the shape of the Mercedes-AMG E63 and Audi S7. So is it good enough to justify such a high premium, and is the specification impressive enough to make it genuinely competitive among such competition? In most respects, yes it is. But in one or two key areas it still lacks some edge beside the best cars at this level. The criticisms primarily concern its ride, which remains no better than mediocre, even with the optional Skyhook electronic damping system fitted, as it was to the test car, and perhaps more surprisingly its straight-line performance. And the problem, once again, is the car's weight. With a driver on board and all the fluids, the Ghibli S weighs not a lot less than 2 tons. So even though its revised 3.0-liter twin-turbo V6 puts out a potent 424 bhp and